Hello viewers, so today our topic is if I have a relative in Canada, then does that gonna help me if I'm thinking of Canada immigration process? So the answer is pretty straightforward, yes, for some cases. And I'm not saying no, but in some cases this is just making no sense. I will describe you why. Okay, so let me recap one more time that point-wise, you need to satisfy 67 points out of 100 points grade. And also, there will be another point grade, which is 1200 points. So you need to score a significant amount out of that 1200, which is about 450 plus minus at this moment. Like, probably if I look back to last a couple of ITA draws, then this is coming approximately somewhere around 450-ish. So, okay, now let's come back to the point. So if I consider that 67 points, so you will find, I'm just sharing the image with you, you will find for the relative, you will have maximum 5 points. Now question comes, so who are those relatives that I can claim the points about? So if I look towards the chart, the relatives included parent, grandparent, child, grandchild, then your spouse's sibling, spouse's aunt or uncle, spouse's niece or nephew. And just to make you a point clear, that all must be within the first blood relationship, and they must have to be Canadian resident or citizen. Because this is not something like they are going to give you the points for the relatives if they are just here as a student or visitor or worker. So that's not gonna help. So they must have to be Canadian citizen or resident. So please make sure you're getting that point very, very clearly. Okay, now let's come to that 1200 grid. So how that helps and what should be the criteria? Now, so out of entire 1200, there are some points for which you can earn additionally. So in that additional criteria, you have the ability to earn maximum 600 points. Now you can see the image that I'm sharing with you. So there are some criterias, like for brothers and sisters, if they are Canadian permanent resident or citizen, you will be getting 15. Then for other, there are some other criteria. You can see I'm not mentioning all of them because those are not that much relevant for most of the cases. Then if you have provincial or territory nomination, that will give you 600, meaning if some of you claim the provincial nomination, you are already getting 600. So there is no point, then you will get these 15 points also, because as you can see above, the maximum point you can claim under additional category is 600. That means if you're already nominated by province, that 600 is gone, and then this 15 point becomes useless. And also, just to point you out, if you can remember in the earlier table, we have seen you can claim points from many other relatives like grandparent, child, aunt, nephew, niece, these, that. But here is only brothers or sister. That has to be sibling or adopted, or can be like by marriage, like if one of your parents being married to someone else, and thereby you get a stepdaughter, a stepbrother, or a stepsister, that is it. So the scope is becoming more narrow here, okay? So keep in mind that for that 100 point grid, there are some options to go for, but for this 1200 grid is only brother or sister, either yours or your spouse's, done. Not many option. And also, if you are getting no provincial nomination point, then there is already 600. That time this 15 becomes useless. So if I want to make some summary, then I would say, like, these 15 points or 5 points, whatever it is, can help you a little bit only. This is not something which will make you or should make you so excited. Okay, I've got somebody in Canada and I'm free to go. No, not something like that, unfortunately. So I would say, please go by yourself. Don't look at others, because if you are in Canada, you will have to work for yourself. right? So that time you will hardly find, even it's a brother or sister, people are so busy here, they will hardly able to help you out, right? So if you have to manage everything by yourself, then why not now, right? So I guess this little informative video was helpful for you if you're preparing yourself for Canada immigration process, especially the express entry. So if you find it helpful, please keep watching, keep subscribing us, and keep sharing with your friends. Okay, so see you on some other next episodes. Okay, bye.